Welcome back. So, life.
I said no. End of story.
Please, Nathan, just this once. All the other girls in my class are going, and I won't be late. I promise, okay?
You're wasting your breath, Jody.
It's just not fair! How come everyone can go and I can't? I do everything you ask of me all week, and I never get to have any fun!
For the 100th time, you're not like everyone else, and there are rules.
Well, I didn't ask to be different. I just want to go out and have friends and be like other girls my age.
You'll never be like them. You need to get used to that. Good night. I'll be next door. Let me know if you need anything.
Let's see.
Stop it, Jody. This is not gonna do you any good. You're grounded, period. Enough! This is getting you nowhere. Are you done? Are you proud of yourself? I hope so. Because you have to clean all that up.
Stop it, Aiden. They don't give a shit if we break everything in this goddamn room. If that's not gonna work, we have to figure out what will.
Yeah, she's calmed down. She smashed up the apartment first, but she's calmed down.
Yeah?
Okay. Sure. I'll see you tomorrow.
I'm really sorry, Cole. I hate myself for doing this, but you understand, right? I need to go out tonight.
All right, hey.
Yeah, I know. It's too late to turn back now. Locked. Of course it is.
Here we go.
Well, hello, Cole.
Jody.
A little late for day trip, isn't it?
Well, it was Nathan's idea. Some kind of, like, night training in the D-Wing. I mean, as if my days weren't enough for his experiments.
It's funny, because, you know, I just spoke to Professor Dawkins and...
He just called my cell. And, I don't know, it's just like a sudden flash of genius or something, and so, he wants me to do this new experiment, but I don't know, really.
Well, you know them scientists, they never stop. What's up, Cole? Cat got your tongue? Hmm?
He's in a really bad mood. He hasn't even said a word all day. He doesn't feel too much like talking today. I think his grandmother died or something. He lost his voice. I think it's like a virus or something. That's more than I've gotten out of him all day long. So.
Well, it's not contagious, buddy. You should be home in bed if you ask me. Safer for all of us. All right, well. See ya.
Hey.
Go on now.
Yes.
Well, at least we don't have to look for Cole's car. There's cameras everywhere. Better not hang around here too long.
Keys. Yeah.
Now get in the car and start it up. Really out of sight.
In the trunk.
That's not the most glamorous escape, but it'll do.
Okay.
You'll forgive me, right? I'll be back soon. And don't worry, I'll be fine. Okay, Aiden, take him into the forest. Make sure he's safe.
Here we go. Bar, beer.
Well, this is the place. Liquor. The girls must be inside already. They're not here yet. We'll wait. Don't need no preacher man to tell me right from wrong. Don't need no real estate to prove where I belong. Don't need no passenger to tell me where to go. Don't need no travel guy to go and steal the show. Just me in the open road, got it going on. My lights tell me where I'm going to.
How old are you, miss?
I'm 21. I just want lemonade. Yeah, I know. Nathan's gonna be pissed.
Super pissed.
That'll be worth it.
There.
Excuse me? Did some girls come in here earlier? I'm supposed to meet them.
No. I ain't seen nobody like that.
Thanks.
Hmm.
told you not to go, and you disobeyed me. You know how dangerous that was for Cole and for you? Hell, Jody, don't you remember Kirsten's birthday party? You know what can happen with Aiden, right? Right?
Everyone else for once.
I know, Jody. I know.
I see. Well. Leave the bar, so they're early, so that's good, I guess, but yeah. So, see you tomorrow. Peace out.